Sarachek Tournament on Max Live.
It's a steal. Sion going the other way. Too easy. I think he just dunked it. It's a throwdown for Daniel Sion.
Bentley, hard drive, gets into trouble, finds Mason. Mason again! You betcha!
He played the station to do it. Couldn't do it there. And Bokard will go up for the dunk! Yes!
Giants to Benami, great bounce pass. Lifeberg, you know you're not going to stop him.
Tucker looking to take him, goes with the left hand. Running floater, and he gets it in!
And welcome back to the Max Stern Athletic Center. I'm Joseph Robin, along with Jack Antrow. We are minutes away from the Tier 3 championship game between the Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem and the MTA Lions. Yesterday, these teams won their Tier 3 semifinal games. Fuchs Mizrahi, a come-from-behind win against MIMO. MTA, they won comfortably against Montreal. Jack, what does MTA have to do to win this on home court?
Well, MTA, we announced their game earlier in this tournament. You know, they're a very young, inexperienced squad. And for this one, this would be a good momentum builder going into next year. You know, 11 juniors on the squad, including four in the starting lineup. And really, their three best players in Yuta Colton and the Bookbinder twins, who we'll see a lot more of today, are all juniors. So they're going to have to control the tempo. Hopefully, the fans will be a factor. We see a few of them filing in with some rally towels. So I think they just got to get the fans on their side and really take it from there.
For Fuchs Mizrahi, they've got plenty of guys who can do it. Yesterday against Maimonides, a couple of their key players fouled out, but it was no problem for them as their bench players picked up the slack and fueled the comeback. Tell us something about that team.
Well, you know, both teams won by double digits yesterday, but it was a much different story. As you mentioned, Fuchs won. They were down by 16 early in the game, and they had a fiery comeback late to win that game. And you know, for Fuchs, it's all about balanced scoring. They have four guys in double figures for the tournament on the average. They have two seniors in Alan Sokolov and Elon Sanders. And, you know, this is it for them. This is the end of the road. You know, it's been a good career for them. And it's going to be ending, hopefully, with a Tier 3 championship, as well as Shmuley Witkus. They're just going to have to score a lot of points. And hopefully, they could steal this one on the road.
Well, tip-off is just a couple of minutes away. Join us and stick around. It's a fun day of basketball. We got the Tier 2 championship game and the Tier 1 championship game coming afterwards. We are just a few minutes away from the Tier 3 game, and we'll be right back.
Where are you going to get such a thing? You have a yeshiva university where you have students come together in a university yeshiva setting. 150 guys at a tish, rocking, singing, really getting involved in what the Shabbos experience is.
In Yeshiva University, I've been lucky to be on both the volleyball and the basketball teams. Being on the team has a huge effect on my academic life. The same way that I know I can push myself in athletics, I know I can push myself in academics. Going to Shiurim at night instead of during the day, or going to them during the day when I've practiced at night, the Judaics is not compromised and the Jewish life is not compromised. We go to other schools and we're wearing our Yeshiva University Maccabees sweatshirt and we're playing for Yeshiva University, it feels amazing to know that we're representing this school. That I can thrive academically, I can thrive in my Judaic life, and I can also be on the teams, and I can also be involved in the athletic life. You can do it all here at Yeshiva University.
There are over 15,000 ways to take your coffee at Dunkin'. Every cup is unique as you, always fresh with that signature smooth taste. We take pride in every cup, but only one is your coffee, your Dunkin'. America runs on Dunkin'.
And we're back here in the Max Stern Athletic Center where we're just a minute and a half away from tip-off. The teams are finishing their pregame drills. Looks like MTA, they're doing, I've never seen this one before, Jack. Looks like they're having a box-out drill, and that's going to be key for them. They definitely have a height advantage over this Fuchs Mizrahi team. I'm sure they're just getting the fundamentals in, also having a good time. We like to see that here in the Tier 3 championship game. And there aren't that many seniors playing in this game. Just 4 for Fuchs, 3 for MTA, and I'm sure it's going to... We'll see if they get in and get some playing time as it's they're wrapping up their high school careers.
Yeah, definitely. You know, one thing to always watch in these games, maybe not as much as in a Tier 3 championship, but if we see some of those guys that you haven't been seeing at the beginning of the tournament, some of these bench warmers, per se, who have a lot of skill, and that's why they're on the basketball teams, but they don't get as much playing time usually. And if they can get in a little bit, it'll be nice to see the fans maybe get a little electric. You know, I was a bench warmer in my high school days, so, you know, the fans always got excited when I got in, and I know the feeling. It's a great one.
And the teams are going over to their sidelines, and Tier 3 championship, good way to salvage a tournament that maybe early on things didn't go your way, but you're able to rally and get home, bring home a trophy. So, we'll see what team comes out on top.
Yeah, you know, one thing to notice, these out-of-town schools, whether they're in the Tier 1 championship or the Tier 3 championship, their fans are still going to show up because they really have nothing else to go to. You know, MTA, maybe they have class, maybe other things going on. For Fuchs, it's really Tier 3 championship or probably another meal at Grandma's, which they've already had a lot of.
And some fans piling in. We're still feeling the effects of daylight savings time. I know personally, I just had to change my alarm clock. I forgot to do that the first day around, but finally got that done. Woke up on time today, and bright and early. You know, we had a game here at 8 o'clock. Barron won the Tier 4 championships, and then Eula won the Tier 1 consolation game. So we're already two games deep. Very exciting day, Championship Monday. One of the highlights of the Yeshiva University year.
Yeah, for sure. You can tell Ellie Hurd is excited. He's the assistant head of recruiting and student activities. He had a very long title over the weekend, but he's got that really nice jersey, the throwback with the lion in the background of the number 21, and he's been giving out rally towels, and we'll see how electric the fans are. You know, we did their game on Friday, and the fans weren't so good.
Yeah, lackluster effort after a disappointing start to the tournament. But, you know, the fans recognize this is a good chance to show some school spirit, get behind their friends, support them, and we'll see if the players react to that support.
Well, you know, we mentioned it on Friday that on Thursday there were a lot of fans because they had school. And now again on today we are on Monday, and it is a school day. Even though it is Championship Monday, they haven't been allowing the schools to get off yet. So there should be some students as there are in session.
Right. On the Fuchs side, he's, you know, pretty well populated. Some alum sitting there. We love to see that. Hopefully he'll continue filling in. I'm sure there are plenty of people listening at home in Cleveland. We'd like to welcome you. And we are in for a good one. Here's the tip. That one won by Yehuda Colton, but it goes directly out of bounds. So Fuchs will get the ball immediately to start the game.
And, you know, I'm sure MTA is going to be telling their Coach Weisberg and co is going to be telling the players, you know, we're the bigger team. We want to keep them out of the paint. We'll see if that comes to fruition. You know, Yehuda Colton is just a very big man inside.
It will be Alan Sokolov getting things started. He'll give it back to Waxman. Back to Sokolov. Back to Waxman. Waxman had a big game against Maimonides to fuel the comeback after Senders and Aaron Waxman fouled out. And an early shot there by Albert Waxman gets Fuchs on the board first.
That was a really nice floater look, and it looks like Fuchs is going to be in a nice 1-2-2 zone defense, and they're going to make MTA shoot it from the outside. We'll see if that works out for them.
MTA will throw it around the perimeter, and it right away goes out of bounds, so Fuchs will get the ball back.
Fuchs is going to let everything in front of them make MTA beat them, as you can already tell by that first defensive possession from the Mayhem.
It's Albert Waxman. He'll give it to Sokolov. Right back to Waxman, who will set things up.
What is a mayhem, Yosef?
You know, not really sure. Not really a noun. Other teams, you know, Lion can really get behind the concept. The Lion's ferocious. It's brave. Mayhem, I guess you just go in there, do your thing, and wreak havoc on the opponent. Kind of like the Minnesota Wild. Was never really sure what that name was about. But anytime you have a team name without an S at the end, I kind of dig it, you know? It's very easy to do the apostrophe S. You know, that's a hard rule sometimes with the sport teams when you're doing recaps, for example. But, you know, the Mayhem, they're getting behind it. They like to hustle a lot. They're all over the court. You see Senders right there pressuring the ball carrier. And I guess they just rally behind it. That shot from the baseline by Bookbinder is no good. Grab by Senders, and he's going the other way. Regains his dribble. And then he loses it right up. It's Ellie Grunberg going end-to-end with the left hand, and he draws contact, goes down hard. Shimmy Jacoby there playing defense.
And Ellie Grunberg has been averaging around 8 points a game in the tournament. You know, the game we did, he fell down in the middle of the second overtime period, and that's really what led to MTA's demise. So he'll have to be a little more careful on the defensive end in terms of foul trouble.
Made a good play there to steal that ball from Senders, who didn't quite have possession when he tried to bring that one up. I'm sure they would have liked to have that ball in Waxman's hands, but we'll see if Grunberg could take advantage.
And you know, an injury concern is Elon Senders. He's a very energetic kid, and apparently hurt his back cheering for the squad when he fouled out yesterday. We'll see if that comes into play.
And he did a lot of cheering from the side. You know, as a starter, it's tough to get fouled out and watch the rest of the game from the sidelines. But he stayed into it. He was very supportive of his teammates. And he was going insane on the sideline during that comeback.
And as we say that, Yuta Colton picked up a foul. And he also, he was hurt, actually. He did not foul it. He was hurt in that game. So that's really what led to the Ida Crown win in triple overtime on Friday that sent MTA to the Tier 3 bracket.
Down low, Shmuley Wickes. He gets rejected by Colton. Great block there. Grunberg the other way. Goes up with it, and it's good. 3-2, MTA has the lead. And the referee talking it over. And just calming things down there. Great block there by Yehuda Colton. He's really got to be a presence if MTA wants to win this one. It'll be Senders now. Takes it inside. Finds Wickes. This time he's not denied by Colton. And he makes the basket.
A couple of lead changes here early, as that was some Swiss cheese defense by the Lions.
And Mirsky gets it to Bookbinder. To Grunberg in the corner. Thinks about the three. Gets it back out to Bookbinder. That one's good.
Nice mid-range shot, as that was definitely what Fuchs wants to give up on defense.
And you don't have to adjust your glasses. You're not seeing double. There are two Bookbinders on the court, number 11 Binyamin and number 12 Yehuda. That time it was Binyamin with the basket. And they'll touch the ball a lot today. Grunberg gets it up court to Mirsky. Somehow stays in bounds on 1 foot. And Grunberg draws a reach in. That was number 3, Jacob Sobel, who committed the foul.
You know, Fuchs has a lot of notable alumni in the stands. President Joel, the president of this university, his son is actually a rabbi in Fuchs, Mizrahi.
Inside for Colton. Goes up with the right hand. It's no good.
He's actually the principal.
Senders starting up the other way. Wickes able to pick the ball up off the ground, and Albert Waxman will reset. 4:30 to go here in the first quarter. MTA holding a one-point lead. Great pass down low to Wickes, not able to get it in. And grabbed there by Binyamin Bookbinder. Last game, Wickes just dominated in the second half. Didn't see much playing time early on, but then once Fuchs got into foul trouble, Wickes came in, and he was just stationed down low, picking up easy layups, and that's what really fueled that comeback. And, of course, it was all Albert Waxman getting him the ball. It was a great 1-2 punch. That long shot by Sokolov is no good. And it goes out off of Sokolov. So MTA will get the ball back with 3:56 to go.
A lot of early fouls by the Mayhem. As three in the early going in the first quarter, you're going to have to be a little more wary in terms of sending MTA to the line.
Coach Oz can't be too happy about that. And it'll be back out for Colton.
Ball finds its way to Grunberg. Now it's Mirsky who shoots a three, and it's good. And more MTA fans are starting to enter the gym, and you're hearing more noise from them as Mirsky knocks down that three-pointer. Four-point lead here with 3:33 to go.
You know, that's the one senior in the starting lineup for the Lions is Mirsky.
That long three by Waxman's no good, and Grunberg wasting no time going the other way. He feeds it back out to Bookbinder. Back out to Grunberg. He's all over the court so far in this game. Back out to Bookbinder. And it's good. Yehuda Bookbinder with a three-pointer. And MTA goes up seven.
Wow, the offense has looked great for the Lions. You know, they're playing in a zone in Fuchs. And they've been forcing the Bookbinders, Grunberg, Mirsky to shoot from the outside. And the both Bookbinder twins look good from mid-range and beyond.
And do you think Fuchs will adjust there and change up their defense, maybe take away that outside shot? Do you think they're still going to try to keep it tight down low?
Well, it'll be interesting to see because coming into this game, the scouting report on MTA was, we don't want to let them beat us with their size. You know, Colton and the Bookbinders are all listed at 6'2 and above, and they've been proving otherwise, so it'll be interesting to see what Coach Oz does if maybe his scouting department was just a little bit off with the game plan.
And we have yet to see number 23, Aaron Waxman for Fuchs. He's a speedy player, good ball handler. Maybe it's a size issue. They want to keep it with the taller players on the court. But nonetheless, Aaron Waxman stays on the bench. We'll see if Fuchs is able to respond. Still plenty of this time in this young basketball game. Albert Waxman shoots a three, and it's good! And that's one way to get back into this one. That's a nice three-point shot by Albert Waxman.
Yeah, both teams are shooting the ball very nicely. You know, only with a little under 3 minutes to go, we've seen a lot of points.
Grunberg gives it to Klein. That's Alex Klein, one of the seniors on the team. Waxman with a steal going the other way. Waxman, no good on the layup attempt. Grabbed by Witkus. His attempt is good. Big basket there for Fuchs.
So now both teams are going to have delay game warnings. Earlier we had MTA, and now there you can hear the ref shouting, even through the headphones, delay of game warning.
So 11-9, MTA has a lead. Five quick points from Fuchs after that timeout. That was a nice steal by Albert Waxman. And good hustle there by Witkus. You know, you see your teammate have a fast break, you might not want to hustle down after it. And Witkus was able to do that. In the meantime, MTA pops a three as I was talking. And MTA's back up five.
You know, the 3-for-3 from downtown. That's definitely not what Fuchs expected from the Lions.
Waxman will set things up. Senders brings it inside. Ball bounces outside. Waxman shoots up another three, and it's good. Trading trades so far in the first quarter.
Very impressive offense. Albert Waxman now has 8 points in the first quarter. And, you know, he's looked good doing it as well.
Grunberg. He'll take a step back. Sets things up. Gets it down low to Colton. We'll see what he can do. Goes up hard. And a travel's called on Colton. Looked like it was going to be a foul, but the ref on the other side of the court saw it differently. So Fuchs will get the ball back.
You know, we haven't seen that many turnovers, as that's only the second for the Lions. So MTA has been playing very well on offense, and that was just an unfortunate mishap.
Sobel tries to feed inside a Sokolov, but it's stolen by Halpert, and MTA gets the ball going the other way. It's Klein, gets it to Bookbinder, to Grunberg. He shoots up a three, and it's good! We're all hitting threes today, I guess. It's 17-12 MTA.
Coach Oz cannot be happy with that defense. You know, they put a little trap on here on the near side corner. Didn't really get much out of it, and it led to a wide open three by Ellie Grunberg.
And MTA is feeling it. Waxman shoots a long three. That one's no good. Witkus with the rebound. Goes up with it. No good. Grab by Sokolov. Second and third opportunities for Fuchs. Back out to Senders. Senders drives the lane. Puts one up. Colton says no. Going the other way is Grunberg. Grunberg takes it one-on-one on Sobel. Off the rim, no good. And it's grabbed by Halpert. MTA to reset. Gets it into Colton. Colton goes up with the right hand. That one thinks about it, and it goes in. Big right hook there by Colton, and MTA extends their lead to seven.
They've just looked great on every possession. Coach Oz has really got to change stuff up here in the intermission break. It's just been an offensive show from the Lions.
6 seconds left. Waxman. He shoots a long three, and it's good! An improbable three-pointer. Grumberg chucks one up, but to no avail. Waxman able to get 3 points back. MTA leads it 19-15 after the first quarter, and we'll be back right after this short break.
Ways to take your coffee at Dunkin'. Every cup is unique as you, always fresh with that signature smooth taste. We take pride in every cup, but only one is your coffee, your Dunkin'. America runs on Dunkin'.
And we're back here in the Max Stern Athletic Center where it's raining threes. Both teams hitting plenty of their three-point shots. It's 19-15, MTA going into the second quarter.
You know, an interesting thing to note on Thursday, MTA lost to EULA. The final score, EULA 38, MTA 19. In today's first quarter, MTA scored 19 points, so MTA's offense has been much improved throughout the tournament.
I wonder what they've been eating, what they changed. Maybe they've been getting more sleep. I don't know. I'm going to have to ask the coach after the game because I think I'm going to start that offensive explosion in the first quarter for MTA and for Fuchs as well, able to keep stride for stride with MTA. Right now it's Mark Gian with it. And that's a long three by Berg. That one's no good. Grab by Senders. And a foul is called on Josh Klein.
You know, it's interesting to know Gian maybe thought it was throwback Thursday night. But to no avail.
Yep. He's wearing one of the older MTA uniforms, it looks like. Slightly different, but still quite fashionable. Sobel has it in the corner. Gets it back out to Waxman. Waxman tosses one up to Yehuda Fant, who's able to corral the ball. Good reception. Now it's Sobel. They get inside to Senders. Senders with a spin move down low to Jacoby. Nice little shimmy over there, but it's no good. And it looks like MTA is ready to sub in five players. Kind of like what Maimonides is used to. They're subbing five in, five out next whistle. That was Fuchs' last opponent. Maybe that'll spark their team into another comeback.
Well, you know, it's very interesting to know who's on the court now for the Lions. A lot of guys we didn't see a lot of minutes from.
And a foul is called on Gian.
You know, David Berg, as we mentioned, a few seniors. He is one of those seniors, and he is on the floor today. It's nice to see him getting in there for a few minutes.
It'll be Jacob Sobel shooting a couple of shots. Fuchs, I'm very impressed with them. They gave up a lot of shots early on. They're able to, you know, stay in the game somehow. Anyway, they saw some baskets by Wickes. And, of course, Waxman hit a couple of long threes. And we have a tight one here. Fuchs cut it down to three. We'll see if they can cut it down to two.
Yeah, Albert Waxman's looked very good in this first quarter. He had 11 points in the quarter, so it'll be interesting to see if he can maybe put on an all-time show today.
Mirsky. Rather, Grumberg. He gives it off to Halpert. Now it's Bookbinder. Bookbinder tried to get it to Saxon, but he wasn't there. Great job by Grumberg to tightrope the half-court line. But that ball is thrown away. Fuchs taking it the other way. It's Senders. Fakes a three, drives a lay-in up with a right hand, and it's good. Colton really bit on that fake shot. Great play there by Senders. And we are tied up now, and a timeout's called by MTA. And they're definitely feeling the pressure as Fuchs comes in, scores four straight points.
Yeah, for sure. I know the defense wasn't there for Fuchs early, but Coach Oz has got to be pleased with the resiliency on offense as they've just continually showed that they can stick with this MTA team. You know, they're a little underseeded. It's the 12 versus the 15, so no signs of that underdog mentality for the Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem.
And the coach is talking over the game plan here. MTA, do you think they're going to try to take more three-pointers here? Looks like they just haven't had a good handle on the ball the last few possessions.
Yeah, you know, the offense was just so dynamic in the first quarter. Maybe we put a jinx on them as they've yet to score through almost 2 minutes here. But you got to attribute that a little bit to some of the substitutions that Coach Weisberg made. Maybe we'll see if the starters come back in and there's more fluidity to the offense.
And it looks like we are going to see number 23, Aaron Waxman, make his way onto the basketball court. He had a big game. And MTA, we'll see how they respond to this late run. And Grunberg will bring up the ball. Facing down the Fuchs defense. He shouts his directions, gets a screen from Halpert. Halpert gets it to Saxon. Back out to Bookbinder. Yehuda Bookbinder takes it with his long right hand. He heaves one back out to Grunberg. Grunberg, couple of head fakes, gets inside, floats one up off the backboard. No good. Good box out there by Senders. He'll take it the other way. Senders takes it hard to the hoop. Goes up and in. Some miscommunication on the defensive end for MTA. And we'll see how they can come back here. Now they're down 2 points. And we're hearing a defense chant from the sideline of the Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem. Their fans are getting into it now. Colton gives it to Halpert. Now it's Saxon. Bookbinder shoots up a three, and it's good. MTA back up one.
This is definitely an exciting Tier 3 championship. Everything we could have asked for from both offenses, but Coach Weisberg is not happy.
And another ejection there by Colton, and it's going the other way. Grunberg takes a step back, slows it down. Saxon now thinks about the three. They try to get it inside to Colton. Witka's a bit too much to handle for him.
You know, they haven't really fouled in a while. They did a good job of resisting to foul.
And Grunberg looking to inbound it from underneath. Grunberg shouting out directions. MTA trying to draw something up. And Bookbinder shoots an open three. That one a bit too far. Grab by Sokolov. Yehuda Bookbinder trying to hit another three from the corner. Waxman puts one against the back rim. Grab by Witka's. Good rebound there. Aaron Waxman now tries to get down low. Feeds it down to Rosenblum. That's no good. Witka's grabs rebound. Back out to Aaron Waxman. He shoots a three. And it's good. Aaron Waxman with a three from the corner.
The Waxman brothers. You know, it was Albert early. And now his brother is getting into the action as Fuchs takes a lead.
And Ellie Grunberg needing an answer here. MTA back down two. Great back and forth action. Albert Waxman a bit too eager. Gets called for the reach.
We already see 9 three-pointers made by both teams here early in this game. We're only midway through the second quarter. And, you know, something to look forward to in this broadcast. We've had a great game going on, but at halftime of this Tier 3 championship, we'll have the privilege of interviewing Coach Jonathan Halpert. Oren Glickman, our esteemed broadcaster for Max Live, we'll be interviewing one of the most legendary coaches, and he'll be talking about different things, including Coach Ritsarchak himself. You know, the reason for Coach Halpert's attendance in this game is for a few reasons, but the main one is his grandson Arye is playing, and he is actually in the game right now, number 20 in white.
And we'll see if Arye can get some points up on the basket for MTA and tie this one up. He's doing the ball handling now.
I saw that coming right away. I was actually watching that as Yehuda Bookbinder is called with the 3 seconds. He was waiting for that feed inside. The entry pass never came, and it's going to be a turnover.
Albert Waxman taking the ball up court. His brother Aaron making his impact felt almost immediately. Albert Waxman now shooting a long three. That one's no good. And good save there by Witkes. And the ball goes off of Yehuda Bookbinder, so Fuchs will keep the ball there. Some great effort hunting down that loose ball.
You know, Albert Waxman, that shot did not go in, but it really looks like he has unlimited range as it was very close, and it's an interesting form he does. He doesn't have a very standard form, but it looks very online every time.
He's trying to get by Ellie Grunberg. He floats one up, no good, off the back rim. Grabbed by MTA. They'll start it up the other direction. It's Ellie Grunberg. You've been saying his name a lot this game. He's been a bit more quiet lately. Klein gets it to Grunberg. Down low, nifty pass to Bookbinder, up and in. That's an easy basket. Great look there from MTA.
Junior to junior, and you know, you can see some of the glimpses of this team next year. A lot of expectations. You know, MTA Sports didn't have such a great year this year, as all four teams failed to make the playoffs. But next year, you know, last year when they were JV, these guys made it to the semifinals in the Yeshiva League, which is an extremely outstanding accomplishment. So we'll see what happens next year, as you can see some of the greatness of the juniors.
Grunberg just misfires on that one. And Fuchs will take it the other way. Number one, Albert Waxman. We'll see if he shoots another long three-pointer, a la Steph Curry. Alan Sokolov gets it back to Aaron Waxman. He has some room. Oh, a nifty over-under move by Waxman, and it's good. And stolen by Witkes. His shot's no good. Grunberg pokes that one free. A little bit sleepy inbound pass there. Great heads-up play by Shmuley Witkes.
Yeah, MTA does not want to get down by any more than they are right now. You know, they're winning for a lot of this ball game, and it's kind of slipping through, especially on offense. It's been a lot sloppier.
And Bookbinder, nice shot, but a charge is called. Great play there by Noah Rosenblum to take the body and draw the charge. And the MTA fans don't like that one. But just a gutsy move to hang in there with a 6'2" Yehuda Bookbinder bearing down on him. And a couple of subs coming in for Mizrahi, including number 23, Aaron Waxman. He'll take a seat. Senders is back on the court. And Albert Waxman inbounding. Senders bring it up court.
It's interesting, you know, Elon Senders is more of a center type guy, but bringing up the ball there.
And Senders has the ball down low. Tries to force it up, no good. Grab by Klein, going the other way. And it will be Grunberg with 1:20 to go. Grunberg looking for some space. Finds Bookbinder down low. Binyamin puts one up. Off the rim, no good. Big rebound there by Witkes, and they'll start the other way. Waxman. Sobel tried to corral the ball. Puts one up, no good. And grab by Binyamin Bookbinder. He'll feed it out. Mirsky up court quickly. Klein with a head of steam. Now it's Grunberg. Throws it across court. Now it's down low for Mirsky. He's stripped of the ball. Good play there by Sobel to get a hand on it. And now Waxman has it with 40 seconds to go.
And MTA struggled throughout the period. They've only scored 5 points after an outstanding 19-point first quarter. So there's going to be some halftime adjustments made by Coach Weisberg if he wants this offense to continue to flourish the way it did in the first. And they probably will see some timeouts maybe in the last 30 seconds.
Obi Senders, nice weave pattern coming along by Mizrahi. Sokolov bounces out to Sobel. He shoots up a long three, no good. Big rebound there by Klein. He'll take it end to end. Not before a timeout is called by Weisberg. And with 7 seconds left, they'll draw something up. It looked like they had some space. Maybe they were able to drive down and make a basket. But Weisberg wanted to take it safe, set up a play. And they've got the time to do it. 7 seconds left.
You know, I knew that was coming as Shlomo Weisberg was asking the scores table if he had used any timeouts. And, you know, we already saw one ill-advised timeout by Coach Weisberg. That one didn't look as bad, but we'll see if they can draw up a nice play here with 7 seconds left to maybe tie or take the lead going into the break.
And who do you think they're going to go to here? You think they're going to set up a shot for Grunberg or try to feed it down low to Colton?
It's a great question, Joseph. You know, if they had a little more time, I would not be surprised if they throw it down low. With 7 seconds, it would be tough to get a nice post-entry pass as they've struggled all quarter that. So, I mean, I'm not the coach, but maybe look for a mid-range jumper by either Halpert or Bookbinder if I was the coach.
And Grunberg inbounding. No one really there to take the pass. They're all set up pretty deep. And they get into Bookbinder. Back to Grunberg with 5 seconds to go. Grunberg, nice move to the hoop with the right hand. No good. And that ball bounces out of bounds. And that will do it for the first half of basketball. Fuchs up 26-24. We'll send it down to the sideline where Dean Liss is with Coach Oz.
Hi, guys. I'm here with Coach Oz. Coach, just one quick question for you. So we saw really in the second quarter your defense really clamped down and trapping the ball handlers, causing a lot of pressure. So I know you're kind of looking forward to keep up that same defense in the second half?
Yes, sir. The whole day yesterday we were, you know, on an emotional high after a big win. So I told the guys to come out here with the same kind of confidence and get ready to be able to take over another half of the game. And they came out kind of flat, but they fought. So it was good. And now we got the lead going into the half.
All right, thank you, sir. Good luck in the second half.
Thanks very much.
Thank you very much for that. We'll send it to the Step It Up Basketball Sleepaway Camp Halftime Show. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome to the Step It Up Basketball Halftime Show on Max Live. Are you ready to step it up? Find out at timetostepitup.com.
Step It Up is not your typical basketball camp. We produce unbelievable results. You will get better here. You will get better as a person. You will get better as a player. That's the Step It Up way.
And we're here back in the Maxar Athletic Center. We'll throw it to the sideline where Oren Glickman is with Coach Halpert.
Welcome back to the Max Stern Athletic Center. I'm Oren Glickman here with a very special guest. It's the legendary former YU Max coach, Mr. Jonathan Halpert. Coach, thank you for coming out here. I really appreciate
it. You're very welcome. Thank you for the opportunity.
Coach, I have a question for you. This is one of the biggest high school tournaments for Jewish teams all over the country, and it's named for Mr. Bernard Saracek, someone you knew very well. Perhaps maybe you can tell the viewers at home who Bernard Saracek, all about him, who he was, and what he meant to this university.
Well, 25 years ago when I started the tournament, the idea was to let everybody know who Red Saracek was. So first and foremost, what you see here today, all these teams, that's because of Red Saracek. Because back when he came to Yeshiva in the 40s, there was no Yeshiva High School League. He started the league. He energized the concept of Yeshiva kids playing basketball in a league. And slowly but surely, the Yeshiva High School League began from 6 teams to 8 teams to 12 teams. And slowly, as the demographics proceeded, now you have Yeshiva High Schools throughout the country. But without Red's influence in building the program at Yeshiva College, at building the Yeshiva High School League, you wouldn't have any of this. So that's point number one. Point number two, Red was considered one of the foremost college basketball coaches, professional basketball coaches back then. In the 40s, there was the American Basketball Association. He won 2 championships. That was the league before the NBA. So he was very well respected. He built the Yeshiva University college basketball program. So from a basketball perspective, Red was really very well known, very well renowned. Although today he would be close to 100, there are still many people, many high school coaches in the metropolitan area who certainly owe their careers, and college coaches owe their careers to Red Sarachek.
And Coach, you're one of the people who had the vision for the Red Sarachek tournament about 25 years ago. Has it been achieved, in your opinion?
Oh, I think beyond my wildest dreams. I mean, when I started the tournament 25 years ago, I never envisioned that there'd be Max Live, streaming live, 1,000 people in the gym. So, yeah, it's exceeded all, exceeded all expectations. And I think it's a tribute to the admissions department of Yeshiva University, to Moshe Kranzler, who had the vision to take the concept and run with the concept. So yeah, this is just fabulous, yes, absolutely. Because it gives Yeshiva kids an opportunity to have a tournament like everybody else. And that's something that Red always wanted very, very much. He wanted to see Yeshiva kids have opportunities to play, and I just took that idea. You know, fortunately, Red only passed away about 9 years ago. So Red had an opportunity to be at this tournament, to see this tournament. And he was, you know, he was very proud of it. And I'm very proud of what I've been able to do. And I just hope this just continues.
And Coach, you're someone who comes to this tournament a lot. You have a grandson participating this year.
Right.
When you come back every year, do you notice a change in the style of play from some of these teams?
Not so much. I think the kids play very hard. I think the quality of play keeps getting better. I think the kids are constantly improving. They're getting better coaching. They're playing more, especially the out-of-town schools, which have an opportunity to play not against yeshiva kids, but against public school kids, because, you know, in New York City, you have 32 kids, 32 yeshivas you can play against. But out in Dallas, you don't have 32. So you have to play against the other schools, and I think that helps them. But no, in terms of style, pretty much the same.
Coach, thank you so much for coming out, and best of luck to your grandson in the second half.
Thank you very much.
At the end of the first, the MTA Lions trailed the Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem by 2. We're going to go to a quick commercial break, but then we'll be back with the second half right after.
And we're back here in the Max Stern Athletic Center. We're going to throw down to the sideline where Moshe Linfield is with Coach Weisberg.
Coach Weisberg, what do you tell your players at halftime to get them ready here for the second half?
Told them three things. In order to win this game, we need to out-hustle, we need to out-rebound, and we need to out-smart Fuchs. We did not do that in the first half, and thankfully we're only down 2. We're going to need to do that in the second half if we want to come ahead and win this game.
All right, thank you, Coach.
And thank you for that, Moshe. MTA, they jumped out to a 19-point first quarter, and they the well kind of emptied, dried out on them. They didn't really do much in the second quarter. Fuchs is now up 2 points. What do you think MTA has to do in the second half?
Well, you know, overall, it was a very slow second quarter. You know, only scoring 16 points combined were the teams. MTA only scored 5 points, and as Shlomo said, you know, they really got to outsmart them. You know, defensively, Fuchs was in that 1-2-2 zone to start the game, and MTA really took advantage of it by shooting from the outside and knocking it down. You know, they're just going to need to play, you know, make halftime adjustments. That's what it's all about. That's where the coaches make their money. And for Fuchs, you know, Albert Waxman only scored 11 in the first and had 0 in the second quarter. And, you know, he looked lethal in the first quarter, especially from long range. So we'll see if that can continue here in the second half.
And the players are making their way onto the court. They will switch directions. Fuchs will be going left to right, MTA right to left.
You know, there are points in this tournament where it seemed that it was going to be over like 85 degrees in this gym, and now it's nice and cool. You hear the nice breeze coming through, so that's a good feeling for the players.
Definite change of pace. I'm sure by the second and first year championships, more YU students and more fans will start filing in, and gym get pretty heated up again. But for now, we'll just enjoy the nice temperature. We won't complain. As Albert Waxman will get it started for Fuchs. He'll go with the right hand up and in. Nice look there by Waxman.
You know, I said just mention his name and he had 0 in the second quarter. Back on the board is Albert in the third.
And Fuchs extend their lead to 4-point lead. Poked free by Waxman. He'll go end to end, but not before Grunberg gets a fistful of arm. So good foul there. And the refs are talking it over. And a discussion going on. Looked like Waxman had a wide open break to the hoop. Interesting foul there by Grunberg to get a hold of his arm, try to slow him down. We'll see what they decide. It looks like they're going to let Fuchs inbound from the side.
A little discussion there by the referees, and Mr. Waxman just wants a little clarification. Nothing too over emotional.
Sokolov gets it into Waxman. He'll start up this offense again. Waxman shoots another long three, and it's good! Albert Waxman, another long three-pointer, and Fuchs is now up 7.
You know, maybe he heard me coming out of the break. I said that he needed to be a little more aggressive after going scoreless in the second, and he's already got 5 early ones here in the third.
Mirsky looking to take back the game for MTA. Bookbinder gets it to his brother. Now it's Mirsky. He finds some room. Nice move to get around Senders, and a nice layup there.
That was pretty weak defense there by the Mayhem. They're going to have to tighten up a little bit if they want to hold on to this lead. You know, the MTA fans, much more respectable here in the second half.
Waxman shoots up another three. That one's no good. Grabbed by Colton. Looked easy for him.
It's nice when you're 6'4" and nice and long arms.
Looked like a regular person holding a ping pong ball almost. Those gigantic arms of his. And a foul is called on Fuchs.
You know, this game is a very exciting one here at Tier 3. But, you know, the day only gets better as it goes on. Tier 2 championship coming up. You see some of the RASG Warriors and the Rambam Ravens walking in. And that should be an exciting one. You know, Rambam undefeated in their Saracek history.
Yeah, that game should be very interesting. We have the preview written up on the Max Live website to get you refreshed. And RASG, I don't know if those of you heard, but they had an intense game-winning basket yesterday against the Ida Crown Aces. They gave up the lead on a three-point shot with 4 seconds left. That tied it up. And then Shmuel Klein somehow found the ball in the air, finished underneath the basket on a long Hail Mary pass. And that one sent them to the Tier 2 championships. And in the Tier 3 championships, Yehuda Colton making his presence felt. He'll go to the line to make it a three-point play.
You know, I actually read a recap on that by Joseph Robin. It was a very good... All right, that's you. That was a great recap you wrote on that game.
And those recaps write themselves. That was a whale of a game, a Saracek classic. We'll be talking about that one for years to come. Just like we'll be talking about this one. This one's back and forth, a great pace set early in the third quarter.
You know, it's nice for Yehuda Colton to have so much size there. As he missed a few of his layups there, got the rebound, went up strong, got the and one, and cut the lead to 2.
MTA 5 points in the second quarter. They have 5 points already in the third. So the adjustments by Coach Shlomo Weisberg seem to have helped. They're back in the game. They're down 2. Senders gets it back to Sokolov. Sokolov met there by Bookbinder. Throws it across back to Senders.
You know, Sokolov's been quiet in their first half and then some as he still held scoreless.
Nice spin move there by Senders. He pirouettes into the paint and he hits the basket. Fuchs back up 4.
That's a very nice use of the vocabulary there. I don't even know what that means, but it was definitely a nice move.
And I'll buy you a dictionary after the game. We could go over it some. Always a good time to extend your vocabulary. Bookbinder back to his twin. He shoots a 3. That one off the back rim. And nice play there by Colton. Poked it to the other Bookbinder. And his shot's no good, so Fuchs able to reset.
You know, there's been a couple of questionable no calls, but Coach Oz for Fuchs doesn't look to be alarmed.
And Albert Waxman, a tough take there off the backboard. MTA wasting no time. Grunberg. He loves the head fakes. That time it didn't work. He'll take it back out.
You know, no risk, high reward there. If you get him to bite, it's nice. If you don't, you just reset where you were before the head fake.
Grunberg finds the ball. He shoots up a 3. That one no good. Just a bit short. Good job by Sokolov to grab that one, and Senders will take it the other way. With a head of steam, tries to get it back out to Sokolov, but it slips out of his hands. And Yeshiva University High School for Boys will start it up. Ellie Grunberg along to Mirsky, now to Colton. He had a bit of a quiet game until that three-point play earlier. We'll see if he could get it going. Binyamin Bookbinder, a long two-point shot. And MTA back down two.
You know, for the Marsha Stern Telemunic Academy, Binyamin Bookbinder is a little more quiet in the first half than his brother. So maybe he'll try to pick up the pace a little bit in the second.
And he has done so. We're halfway through the third quarter of play. 33-31, Fuchs lead. The MTA fans broke out in a defense chant. They're starting to get into it. Now Fuchs sideline quieted down some. Waxman finding no room by Grunberg, but a bit too physical as a foul is called.
And the fans are going to hear little boo birds here from the MTA Lions faithful. As that was a questionable call on Grunberg.
I'm a little disappointed. I was hoping we'd see the MTA mascot. They've got a nice costume, but they didn't break it out for this Tier 3 championship game. Yeah. Maybe he's just in the den a little longer. He'll make his appearance late in the fourth.
Yeah, that's definitely a good call. You know, we see him walking around the den sometimes at random times throughout the night, so.
Albert Waxman puts one up with a right hand. Highly contested shot, but great job by Jacoby to find the rebound. And Waxman will get it back. And before he could let his shot out, a foul is called on MTA.
I know, that was a long, long, long range three by Waxman. It didn't count, but if that would have went in, might have brought the house down.
And Fuchs will get the ball back. It didn't go in, so they're happy that foul was called. Waxman will shoot another three-pointer. That goes off one of the supports. He kind of puts a hand on his head, a little disappointed with himself. Hey, if you're feeling it, you're feeling it. But maybe it's about time he starts going back to more traditional ways of getting points.
Well, you know, I heard in the Fuchs Mizrahi practices they actually shoot that corner three. They haven't made that adjustment with the white beams there, so it'll be interesting to see. You know, it's been three games already, but...
And Colton gets it out to Mirsky. Mirsky, it's his last game of his high school career. I'm sure he's going to really bring in the second half. Great play there by Grunberg to draw contact. He'll go to line for two.
You know, you can't really be making those assumptions, Joseph, as the All-Star game is still in late May, and you never know who makes those games, as sometimes you see some surprising stars come into that game and really make a great last impression.
Well, the last game that matters for him anyway. I don't think MVP of the high school game gets a car, as they do in the pros. I don't know. Do you know that?
You know, I've never been in attendance for one of those games. They usually play them in, you know, like the Hawaii of the tri-state area. You know, sometimes we send them out to Westchester.
Ah. Well, maybe we'll make our way out this year. As we've seen a lot of talent coming from these teams in Saracek, so that'll be a great event, as I'm sure it always is. Senders. He loses the handle on the ball, but it goes right to Waxman. He loses the handle on the ball, somehow finds it, and he gets fouled going up with it. That foul is on Grunberg. He disagrees with it. And Waxman will go to line for a couple of shots.
Well, that looked like a foul to me. I don't know about you. It looked like a pretty hard foul,
yeah,
honestly.
It was definitely contact made. And a lot of players losing the handle on the basketball here. Maybe these players had some of our Dunkin' Donuts before the game. They're one of our sponsors. We'd like to thank them. In addition to our other sponsors, Roast Home Style Chicken, the Westchester Dermatology, Sammy's Bagels, and of course, Five Star Catering. We thank you very much.
I don't know. I heard maybe, you know, some precipitation outside, a little bit of rain early. They weren't wearing their gloves. They got a little wet, and that's where you've been seeing some slippery hands.
And Gian comes on the court. Looks like Grunberg might start to get into a little bit of foul trouble. He's talking it over with Coach on the bench. He'll, you know, get some composure back.
Well, that was his third foul on that last possession, so definitely something to watch throughout this ballgame.
And if they lose him for any amount of time, that is something to note. Halper puts up a shot. No good. Nice rebound there by Gian. He gets it down low to Bookbinder, and he converts the layup. MTA down one with 2:20 to go.
And it's great to hear those fans. You know, it makes the game that more exciting.
And Senders looking for a response. So it's Jacoby. Jacoby back out to Senders. Senders finds the open lane. That's easy for him. A nice basket. And they extend the lead to three.
Coach cannot be happy with that one. You know, Shlomo Weisberg preaches defense this whole year, and that was just a...
And going the other way, some space down court. Klein took that from the hands of Colton, pretty much. Colton was wide open. Klein thought that pass was going to him, and his layup attempt was from behind the basket, so it was no good. Senders the other way, looking to take advantage. He tries to feed the ball to Sokolov, but not on the same page, and the ball dribbles out of bounds.
You know, the expression, a head scratcher. Shlomo Weisberg was scratching his head after Alex Klein took that layup as Colton looked to be under the hoop and ready for the layup.
Not the first MTA line to take points out of the hand from Colton this weekend. Gian taking it end to end. A long 3-point shot by Bookbinder is no good. Grab by Halpert. Good hustle to get to that board. That one's poked out of bounds, but the referee says it's off of an MTA player. Shlomo Weisberg doesn't agree. Neither do the MTA fans. I don't agree myself, but that's what the ref saw, so Fuchs gets the ball back with 1:18 to go.
And it looks like Elon Senders, you know, they're from Cleveland. They just saw the cut of Johnny Manziel, but he's going to stick with that Johnny Manziel play call that they called earlier in September.
And Manziel, controversial football player. I'm a Cincinnati Bengals fan, so, you know, I was kind of happy with Manziel calling the shots for Cleveland. Pretty entertaining. We benefited with those wins, so not going to complain. And we'll see if they can channel his emotion. It's Klein.
It wasn't surprising that on that possession with the Manziel call, it was a turnover.
And that ball is saved by Halpert, but right to the hands of Aaron Waxman. He'll get things going for Fuchs. Albert Waxman now. Shakes Gian, puts one up off the glass, gets the rebound, and it's good. Another couple of points there for Waxman.
Yeah, you know, Fuchs' offense has looked good as the MTA. It's more of a lack of defense. There's a lot of layups for the Mayhem.
And now it's inside. That's number 10 for MTA, Zach Fish. He draws contact. He'll go to the line. He's all pumped up. Rather, he won't go to the line. It goes out off of Fuchs. But some energy from the MTA bench. They're really going to a lot of their players. And there's a lot of emotion coming from that sideline. And Bookbinder gets it into Gian. Thinks about a pass inside, decides not to. Fish gets it to Bookbinder. Bookbinder with time winding down. Halpert shoots a three. That one's good! And now one last chance for Fuchs. They get it down court. And the shot does not come off before the buzzer. Doesn't go in anyway. It's Fuchs holding a 39-37 lead. We will be back right after this commercial break.
In Yeshiva University, I've been lucky to be on both the volleyball and the basketball teams. Being on the team has a huge effect on my academic life. The same way that I know I can push myself in athletics, I know I can push myself in academics. Going to Shiurim at night instead of during the day, or going to them during the day when I've practiced at night, the Judaics is not compromised and the Jewish life is not compromised. We go to other schools and we're wearing our Yeshiva University Maccabees sweatshirt and we're playing for Yeshiva University. It feels amazing to know that we're representing this school. I can thrive academically, I can thrive in my Judaic life, and I can also be on the teams, and I can also be involved in the athletic life. You can do it all here at Yeshiva University.
And we're back here in the Max Stern Athletic Center, where Fuchs is holding on to a 2-point lead over the MTA Lions. We're in for a great fourth quarter, I'm sure. We're gonna see some players step up. We're gonna see some baskets made, and we're gonna see a great finish.
Yeah, you know, this game has been very good. Albert Waxman showing off some of his great long-range basketball shooting skills. And if you wanna send in a comment, send it to the Clipped Keeper inbox, feedback@maxlive.com. You know, last time we did this MTA game, Shlomo Weisberg's family was watching from all sorts of places in the country, between Chicago, Israel, and different places in Israel, you know, specifically.
Right.
And so we'll see if maybe they're watching again today, Tier 3 Championship. That shows dedication.
And the fans are all excited. They're ready. I hope you're ready. Right off the inbound, a wide open lane there for Bookbinder. No one was home for Fuchs Mizrahi. Maybe they forgot what direction they were going. I don't know. But inexcusable defense, and we're tied up with 7:45 left in the game.
You know, we watch sometimes some third to fifth grade hockey when we referee. Sometimes they get confused in between periods as they don't know which way they're going. That's what it looked like on that defensive sequence.
And that was Benjamin Bookbinder. He had all the room in the world, and he took advantage with a 2-point basket. We'll see if Fuchs has an answer.
You know, Coach Oz definitely is stressing that this is the last quarter of the season. Especially for some of these seniors, this is it for them. They got to show as much intensity. Leave it all out on the floor is what I'm trying to tell you.
And Gian trying to do that for the MTA side.
And, you know, MTA throughout the whole season preached defense and slow-paced offense, and we'll see if they try to do that here in the last 7.5 minutes.
It's Klein looking for a teammate, decides to do it himself. Gets it down low to Fish. Fish draws contact. He'll go to line for two. And he is pumped up. Yep. He hasn't been on the court much this tournament, but there, great play down low.
You know, Zach Fish, they call him sometimes the X Factor. He came in here late. There was no scouting report on him. And, you know, sometimes when you see, like, for example, in baseball, you see a pitcher for the first time, and he throws that great complete game shutout, and everyone's asking why. Well, there's no scouting report, and that's what happened with Fish there inside. You know, they didn't know the post move. They didn't study the film over the weekend, and he's really showing it at the free throw line that he can hit.
Calm, cool, and collective there, and he gives MTA the lead. Coming in, a trio of players for Fuchs Mizrahi, including number zero, Shmuley Witkes. And he had a great game against Maimo. We'll see how he does down the stretch here. Also coming on is number 23, Aaron Waxman. A great ball handler. Fish hits them both. So MTA now up to 7 minutes to go. Albert Waxman. Sitting at 18 points. Rather 20.
You know, we talked about in the opening how four guys for the Mizrahi Mayhem average double digits. Right now it's just Waxman.
And that ball squirts loose. And we'll see where the ball goes. Looks like it will be Fuchs' ball.
You know,
they'll hold on to it.
You know, Zach Fish, cool, calm, collect at the free throw line, but hard hunger hustle on the defensive end with that play, as that was a nice play, and you see the energy he's bringing, jumping up and down here, guarding the inbounds.
Doing jumping jacks, doing anything he can. He's just a ball of energy. Gets the ball inside to Sokolov. Not giving centers any space.
Here's some monkey noises coming out of Fish, so maybe he's confused with his animal.
And a foul called on Fish. He is not happy. And, you know, sometimes you want to play that tight defense, but the refs, if they're going to call it, they're going to call it. So he's got to lay off a little bit here. Six fouls for MTA. Sokolov gets the ball down low to Senders. Senders goes up with it, and it's good. Tied at 41.
You know, you say six fouls on MTA. Now, Fuchs is shooting 100% from the line today. Minimum two attempts. They have four. So they're 4 for 4 from the line, and that's definitely something to keep an eye on for MTA.
And Grunberg looking to regain the lead for the MTA Lions. MTA fans getting behind him. It's Halpert. Halpert back to Klein, taking their time here on the offensive side. Waxman trying to force a turnover. And foul is called there on Fuchs.
That was a very hard double team, which we got note of from the sideline on the list that Coach Oz said, double the guy on the ball and then try to get a guy, the weak side defender, to come in and steal the pass. And we saw some of that double team, but just a little too anxious to get the ball. And you saw Kipa go flying. You know, clip Kipa inbox, feedback at maxlive.com if you want to send us a shout out, maybe a note, maybe we're saying something wrong, maybe you don't agree with the Johnny Manziel turnover line.
I don't think there'll be so many who disagree with that one. Halpert gives it to Colton. Colton far away from home, which is underneath the basket, to clarify.
He's actually pretty close to his home in Teaneck, New Jersey.
And Grunberg with it. It's been a while since he hit a three, hit a bunch early on. Tries to get it down low, but loses the handle, and Fuchs will get the ball back. Tie game with 5:20 to go. We'll see who steps up. Is it Shmuley Witkes from underneath the hoop? There was some contact there, no call. Refs let him play. Good defense there by Binyamin Bookbinder. Fine now. Tries to lose Waxman, but he gets Senders instead. Goes up with it, no good. Hunts down his own rebound. Colton not able to hold on. And now a loose ball foul is called on Sokolov, as he goes in hard and low.
You know, the senior,
And it looks like MTA will be shooting 1-1 here. They reach the bonus. You know, it will be Binyam and Bookbinder doing the shooting.
You know, both teams are now going to be shooting free throws the rest of the way, the last 4:53. In this tie ball, and that's usually what makes or breaks the end game execution.
And right there, nice free throw shooting by Bookbinder. Looking to make it a 2-point lead with just under 5 minutes to go. No good. Fuchs gets a rebound. They could take the lead here. Senders taking his time, bringing the ball up court. Senders back out to Sokolov to Waxman. He puts a three up, and it's good. He came here as a Wax boy. He's going to leave as a Wax man. A three-point shot by Albert.
That was gorgeous. When he hits those threes, they really, the whole audience knows it as it goes right through the net.
And a big shot here. Fuchs goes up two. Halpert puts up a three, and that's good. MTA fights back. A tug of war coming here. Fuchs looking to respond. Senders gets it out to Sokolov. He does it himself. That one off the side of the backboard. Senders hunts down the rebound. Sokolov shoots another three-pointer. That was just a bit short. Wick is not able to grab the rebound. Interesting move there. Sokolov, once he got the ball, he looked at Waxman, thought about passing it to him. He had him wide open, but decided to play hero himself, but his shot was no good. Got the rebound. His second shot was no good. Got to get the ball back to Waxman. He's really feeling it here. Nice rebound by Sokolov as he avenges his earlier mistakes. Waxman takes it end-to-end. Wick is down low. That one no good. Takes a trip around the rim before falling into the hands of Halpert, and Grunberg will slow things down.
You know, it's no Stanley Cup, but you see the Tier 3 championship being brought around, ready to be handed out after this one. A lot of great players have held that one.
Bookbinder called for the travel, a bit too eager. We see that a lot in Yeshiva basketball, that early step. And Bookbinder gets nailed for it there. Fuchs down one with 3:06 to go.
You know, Alan Sokolov playing his last ever game. The senior. A lot of great times here for him as this is it for him. These are his last 3 minutes and 6 seconds, and we'll see how he can respond. You know, he's held scoreless early, held scoreless throughout, and still looking for his first points, but he had a big rebound on that possession. We'll see if it translates to offense.
It's not about who starts the game, it's about who finishes, as they say. We'll see if he could have a strong finish. A nice cherry on top of his career. Wick has down low. Well, a no-look basket. That was really nice from him. And Fuchs back up one.
Yeah, you see a lot of the Cleveland alumni, the Fuchs Mizrahi alumni. You know, sometimes we call them by their states, the school, or cities in this case. But some notables out there in the crowd.
And a timeout there called by Coach Weisberg. They want a perfect possession here, down one. And listen, this is going to be a great finish. We knew it was coming. It has been punch for punch throughout. Who do you think is going to step up here at the end?
Are you asking for my prediction?
I'm asking for a prediction, Jack.
You know, I thought MTA has been the better team, even though they are down one. But Fuchs has continued to show it's not about height. It's about heart. And, you know, Elon Sanders is a little undersized in the paint. But he's been putting up a great game. He has 10 points on 5 of 6 shooting from the field. And in general, just anytime they look down, Albert Waxman has been there for a big three, a big two, a great dish, and a layup, and he's just been doing it all for the squad, keeping them in this ball game and ahead by one. So if Albert Waxman continues the way he's been throughout, I could see Fuchs holding on. But other than that, MTA has got the fans, they got the home court advantage, they know this team better than anyone else, and you know, they want to prove to the rest of the national media that they are ready for next year, take a big jump, and try to get into the Tier 1 of next year, Sarachek.
And this would definitely be a confidence builder for them if all of these juniors can bring home the glory of Tier 3 championship. On the other end, I think Fuchs could have a strong team next year, too. A lot of returning players like Albert Waxman and his brother Aaron.
They are not twins.
They are not twins, but still blood.
Albert is older, for those wondering at home.
That is correct, Jack. Thank you for that. Inbounding will be Bookbinder. He finds Colton. Nice give and go. He'll be back out to Grunberg with 2:30 to go. Grunberg looking for an open receiver. Finds his man in Binyamin Bookbinder. Gets it to Yehuda. Down low. Goes up. Makes the basket and the foul. He'll go to the line to make it a three-point play. Great effort down low by Yehuda Bookbinder. A nifty feed by Binyamin. And pure greatness looking to go up two with 2:22 to go. Deuces are wild.
And you know, as we hit the noon hour, a lot of the YU students come in for lunch. Maybe we'll see a lot of the fans piling in here toward the end of this one.
That foul shot was no good, so Fuchs down one. Senders controlling the ball. Defense chant erupts from the MTA sideline. Senders fights his way down low, and he muscles the ball into the hoop. A nice basket.
And you know, Elon Senders, as I mentioned at the last time out, he might not be the biggest guy in the court, but he's been playing very well inside. Now 6-for-7 from the field.
Grunberg, while falling down, able to throw that ball up and in. A big basket. 49-48, MTA has the lead. On that last possession, after making the basket, it looked like Fuchs wanted to press, but some of the players forgot about it. And a travel now called on Senders, so MTA gets the ball back.
No, bucket, 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 back and forth and back and forth. This is exactly the action that the fans want, and this is exactly what the players want. You know, the players are very excited by this Tier 3 championship. We mentioned the trophy in the building. They could taste the greatness that they could be on this, the big banner, you know. The Tier 3 banner is just as big as the Tier 2 banner.
And the MTA fans bring out an MTA chant, and Devlo wide open is Bookbinder. He'll convert that one. MTA up three with 1:30 to go.
And you know, very much lacking in the defense by the Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem.
And Fuchs just giving up easy baskets the last couple of possessions. Coach Oz must be kicking himself there, not liking what he's seeing. And they've got to come up with a way to stop that. And they also need a three-pointer. I'm sure we will see Albert Waxman get a couple of touches. We're going to keep it here. We're moments away. 1:29 left. This is going to be a great finish. And like you said, a lot of YU students filing in for a great finish. They're pretty lucky. They missed a great game up until now. They're going to be treated to a fantastic finish. And if you're joining us for the next game, we'll be with that shortly after this one.
Yeah, you know, if they're not at the game live, they're watching online, and therefore they can send to the Clip Keepa inbox at feedback@maxlive.com. You know, you're watching at home, you're studying, you're eating your lunch, you're eating your pizza, and you just want to send us a message. We're gladly ready to accept it. As this game has been up and down, you want to ask us about who's been playing well? We'll answer that one as well. Who has been playing well, Joseph?
I'll tell you who's playing well. Number one, Albert Waxman. He has been dominating this game. He is all over the court, and he will definitely be the go-to guy. Also, Elon Senders for Fuchs. He's been getting a lot of touches down low and converting a lot of baskets. Was called for a travel last possession, but he is looking to make up for that here.
And, you know, we got a shout-out, a few, but we'll just go quickly. Did someone actually admit to being a Bengals fan on live TV? Alert the authorities. That is from drobin14 at Verizon.net. I wonder if that's related to Joseph.
And we won't talk about that now. There is a game on hand. A big three there by Waxman, and he hits it from a mile away. And he gave a look to the booth, and he says, yeah, I just did that. We're tied up with a minute to go. 68 seconds left, and a timeout called by MTA. I cannot believe the performance that Albert Waxman has done here today.
You know, that's
wow.
That's his 6-3 of the ballgame. He's got 26 points. You know, he had an 11-point first quarter, cooled off in the second, but he has just been incredible here throughout the end as three after three, and they haven't been wide open. They haven't even been that close to the line. They've been long-range threes.
And with they're going to talk it over here. And I'm sure MTA will try to get it to the Bookbinders. They've also had a great game. You know, both of them, both contributing greatly. And I expect that will continue down the stretch.
And you know, we have another shout-out from the Clip Keepa inbox. Tuning in from the Gush, proud alumni of MTA and Fuchs. I assume that's a husband and wife. And they got a steak dinner riding on this one, so
whoever's the alumni of Fuchs has got to be happy with Albert Waxman. They got him that much closer to a steak dinner. You know, hashtag Waxman dropping 30, hashtag bookbinder for the tray. And Waxman may be dropping 30 as he has 26 points with a minute and 8 seconds left.
And we'll see if MTA has an answer. Tied up late. Bookbinder gives it to Halpert. Halpert gives it to Colton. Colton back to Halpert. Ball pops loose. Senders tries to poke it free. And it'll be Grunberg. Loses Waxman. Grunberg thinks about shooting. Throws it across. Bookbinder for three. No good. Off the back rim. And off the hands of Grunberg. He disagrees. And Fuchs will get it with 43 seconds left.
I don't know if that was as much of a disagreement as a mix-up with him and Colton, as it looked like two guys from the same team were going for that rebound. And Fuchs is going to maybe hold for one here with 43 seconds left and the ball.
A popular strategy here at Saratech with no shot clock. Teams will often drain the clock. Then they'll call a timeout late. Or rather, they'll take their timeout now with 37 seconds left. And a lot of discussing going on. We've had a few timeouts lately. Just talking it over, the coaches, they want to do it right. A derogatory nickname for Cleveland is Mistake by the Lake. They can't afford to make a mistake here.
That is definitely a good point, Joseph. As, you know, 37 seconds left, it's not that much time to hold for one. We've seen a lot worse. And Fuchs switched into that man there on the defensive possession, and they got bailed out by an open jump shot that they gave up, and it was just missed. And then the rebound, another unlucky play for Fuchs. So they got a few lucky breaks on defense, and now on offense. We got to see Albert Waxman. I don't even know what else to say. The guy's been shooting it from the volleyball lines. You know, maybe he thinks he's playing volleyball, the four-point shot, if he's in the Harlem Globetrotters. So far, that's been the story for him tonight. And, you know, with 37 seconds left, you got to assume it's going to be Waxman once again.
You got to assume that, or maybe they'll even use him as bait, set up a backdoor play to Senders. He also has been dynamite this afternoon. 37 seconds left. RESG Warriors making their way onto the court. They have their Tier 2 championship game coming up next. Please stick around for that one. That will be a delight. And at 2 o'clock, we've got the championship game, DRS against Shalhevet. We've got a great day of basketball, and it's starting with this finish.
You know, as is the case when all these games get great that we announce, yeah, the clipped Keepa, I mess that one up every single time. The clipped Keepa inbox has been blowing up, and you know, Fuchs legend Akiva Laumann is sitting courtside. Is that possible motivation? That's what Keenan Sobel, maybe related to Jacob Sobel, I believe is his name. So a legend for Fuchs sitting on the sideline here. Maybe motivation.
And Senders will get it started with 34 ticks to go. Looks like he'll take some time to get it organized. Zach Fish laying off a bit. Now he approaches him, making those monkey noises that we mentioned earlier. Nice scare tactic. Waxman comes back for the ball. 15 seconds. Sokloff now gets it to Waxman. He's the man you want to have the ball. Senders wants the ball back. 8 seconds.
And it looks like it's going to be a clear out maybe for Waxman. Oh, he's feeling it.
Waxman now, as time drains down, shoots a long three. And it's good with 0.3 seconds left. And the clock drains there. And that will do it. Albert Waxman drains a three. And your Tier 3 champions is the Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem.
I said that you knew he was going for that clear out. He shot it from the volleyball lines.
And that will do it. 54-51. Fuchs gets the win. We'll be back right after this commercial break.
There are over 15,000 ways to take your coffee at Dunkin'. Every cup is unique as you, always fresh with that signature smooth taste. We take pride in every cup, but only one is your coffee, your Dunkin'. America runs on Dunkin'.
I came to IU to pursue a further Jewish education. Participating in a collegiate athletic team has been challenging. Yeshiva University provides an incredible opportunity to find a balance between academics, athletics, extracurriculars. Fellow students show their pride for their teams in coming to games like Max Madness, our senior night, wearing their blue and white colors. The Yeshiva University Athletics Department breaks the stereotype of what it means to be a Jewish athlete. So while I came here for a Jewish education, I'm walking away with much more.
Thank you.
צלול קיים וריח אורנים ניסה ברוח ארבעים עם כל פעמונים ובתרדמת אילן ואבן שבויה בחלומה העיר אשר בדד יושבת ובליבה חומה ירושלים של זהב ושל נחושת ושל האור הלא נחוש יראיך הניחינה
And we're back here in the Max Stern Athletic Center where Albert Waxman just beat the buzzer and gave Fuchs Mizrahi the victory. Congratulations, guys. How does it feel?
Feels great. The championship's great to get for Cleveland. We've never won this before. So it's great to get it for my boy. It's the last time I ever get to play with him.
I would say it's successful because I've been up here 3 out of 3 times. So I guess I played pretty well.
Same. This is the big two right here, man. He's about to be a fifth-year senior. We need him back.
Guys, you know, Elon, you're listed at 6'1", but down there in the paint, you played awesome, but you looked a little undersized. What did it feel like to be, you know, 6'1", but playing against
the guys? He eats a lot of burgers. It helps him out.
Being undersized has never been a problem for me because what I lack in height, I make up in weight and strength. So, I mean, these big, skinny kids need to hit the gym.
Yeah.
You guys had a big comeback against Maimo after I think you two fouled out.
I can handle this.
No, his brother.
Oh, his brother fouled out. So talk about the team, how they rallied in two big games.
I think we just believe we're a tier one team that got stuck in tier three. You know, we feel like we're underranked, undervalued, overlooked, whatever word you want to look for. That's what we came into this tournament to do. We're 3-1. We should have been 4-0. We should have beaten Cooper. You know, we feel like this is going to give us a platform to build that we could be a tier one team in the future. And also, everybody who's coming into high school, get ready because I'm about to destroy you in practice.
Also, the takeover of Coach Oz, the Wizard of Oz. I like that, by the way, whoever came up with that. The takeover of him coming in really changing what this program is about and changing it for the better. And the work ethic that he makes us go through is insane. He's an Army. He's a past Marine, so you know he puts us through hell.
He's a beast! He's a beast! The game winner!
And congratulations, guys. Great win, great tournament, and that will do it with us. Stick around for the Tier 2 Championship game. For Jack Antro, I'm Joseph Robin.
Hey,
have a good day.
Shout out to everyone watching in Cleveland. We love you. Thanks so much
Dr.
for watching.
Thank you for letting everyone watch the game in the hallway.
I should get a free 4.0 for this trophy.
Let's go.
Thank you. Congrats.
There is no group of people like the students you'll be with. There's no faculty and group of Rebbeim like those with which you will learn that can begin to compare to the experience at Yeshiva.